guys, what's up? And today I'm going to be talking about batteries. Everything about batteries, their voltage, their capacity, how they measure, and everything. Now, this video is planned to be explained on the whiteboard, so let's go. Here I have the board, and you might have noticed that, well, these edges are improved. I've just, you know, made my own using chart paper and improved the background and everything. So first, let me tell you that this is going to be split up into two. The first episode is going to be what you are seeing right now. We are going to talk about batteries, voltage, capacity and current. While in the second episode, we'll be talking about the two ways of connecting batteries. So let's look at this. So here I've written a fact that within the size 3600 mAh, well, actually more than 3600 mAh is not possible. So if you see any brand claiming that their 18650 battery is more than this, then it means it's a scam. But what is milliampere hours? Well, it's written in MAH in the capital and the MH in the small letters, and here I have written the spellings. So 1000 milliamperes equals 1 ampere. Oh, yeah, sorry. 1 ampere. So if you have a 2000 mAh battery, that means it's the same as 2 ampere hours, AH. And that means if you put a 2 ampere drain on that battery, then it is going to take an hour to run flat. Or even the same battery, you know, this one, this is just an example, by the way. So if you put a 1 ampere drain, it's also going to take 2 hours. If you put a 4 ampere drain, it's only going to take 30 minutes, and so on. You got the point. Now, there is a limit of how much current drain can be put on the battery, and you have to ask that from the seller you are buying the battery from. Like, if the current drain that you're... If the current drain you're putting on the battery is not supported, then, well, it may result in some damage. 2000 mAh is quite a lot, right? Well, it depends. Again, current drain. You have to be careful on how much current your, you know, whatever you're using is taking. How much current it is consuming. If it's taking a very little amount of current, less than 1 ampere, then like it's going to take a lot of time to run flat. On the other hand, if it is taking a lot of current, then first you have to be sure that it is within the current drain range of the battery, and then you have to be sure that the capacity of the battery can handle it for the desired amount of time before it runs flat. So that was milliampere hours as well as the current. What about voltage? Well, batteries have a fixed amount of voltage in the fully charged state. Some batteries are rechargeable and some are not. The normal AA and AAA size batteries that we use in our toys, wall clocks, TV remotes and so on, all of those are 1.5 volt. Some are made out of carbon zinc and some out of alkaline. So those batteries are not rechargeable, that's why when, well, they're dead, we just throw them away. When a battery has a specific amount of current drain, the more current being drained on the battery, the quicker it's going to run flat. The quicker it's going to discharge. Discharge is the opposite of charge, that when you are losing power, when it's getting used up. The rate of discharge depends on how much capacity you have. I'm just going to make brief videos like this, small and not that much into detail.